Right. I had a client that their kid never went to school and they couldn't use the money. They had to pull it out and get taxed. Well, then I could go over, well, hold on here. An IUL for kids is different. And let me show you, right? And have that conversation. Because I'm sure a lot of you guys have clients and teammates that have kids, right? This is where that conversation could come in. Understand the product. Then we go to annuities. There's a lot of annuities that everybody's doing right now. Well, what is an annuity? Again, go back to the basics. Watch the video.
Seems like retirement plan.
Not only watch the video, but go in to Nationwide if you're going to provide Nationwide. Learn how to run the illustration, right? Learn how to run the guaranteed income tool. That way you could describe it to the client. Hey, client, if you stop, or I'm sorry, if you start taking income in year six, what happens to the other 4 years? Right? Learn that. Know your tools. Go to AMS. Do you know that AMS is where a theme is where you get a theme? Right? Well, some people don't know. They think they go straight to a theme. No, you go through AMS. Well, what is AMS? Right? Go in there, understand it again. Because not only do I see that, sometimes maybe we don't understand it, but if we can't explain it to our teammates, how can they trust us? Right? How can they trust us? And there's a theme there. Next, term LB. What is term LB? All right, what is it? Well, again, it's a strategy that we could help people with. It's something that we can add to an IUL. Once again, go to myagentcenter.com, watch the video, right? Get the basics. Also, understand the questions. If somebody has a term LB, will my premiums remain the same every single year if I got a 10, 15, 25, or 30-year plan? Right? An example, I had a client that handed me her documents and said, Eddie, why does my premium go up year 10? Can you explain to me? Right? Are you able to explain that to the client? Or do you know the units per cost of insurance? What does that mean? Right? Well, if you know it and you explain to the client, again, they're going to trust you. Wow, this guy knows what he's talking about. But if I can't do that, how can they trust me? How can I complete the sale? How can my teammates trust me if I can't explain it to them? And last, Everest, right? Understand that product. Why? Go to the website. Understand what is Everest? How does it work? Matter of fact, I also use Gerber, right? Some people don't even know what that is. Why? Because again, I go into my agent center, right? And I learn the products. I understand, hey, if Everest doesn't work out for the client, Gerber accepts everybody. Matter of fact, my uncle has cancer. They accepted him. They do not deny anybody. Gerber will take everybody. So if Everest does not work out for you, you could go Gerber. Hey, for those in New York, you can't sell Everest out there, right? They don't allow you to sell Everest. So guess what? Go Gerber. But if you don't understand the products, if you don't know the tools, then that's something that you're missing out on, right? Something you can't help your client on. So, next, the market, right? Johnny wanted me to talk a little bit about this. Just touch on it. So, what do you need to know about the market? Is it going up and down? What's the health of the market? Well, you got to understand the basics, guys. You don't have to go in and out about the market. What's ETFs? What's options? What's put options, call options? None of that stuff, right? Just know the basics, right? What's the NASDAQ? What's the S&P? What's the Dow Jones? Right? Why? Because if a client comes and asks you, hey, what's the health of the market today? What are you going to tell them? If you didn't read into it, if you didn't listen to what the market's doing. Well, how about if a client says, here's my 401k investment sheet. Can you explain where my money is being invested? That happens a lot, guys, right? Don't you guys ask if somebody wants to roll over their 401k or is losing money in a 401k and you ask for their sheet, their PDF sheet? I could look at it and see like, wow, you're being invested in small caps or mid caps, right? I could explain to them where their money is being invested and why they're losing it, right? If you know the basics, you're able just to look at it, understand where the money is being invested and why they're losing it. Guess what? They're gonna trust you because they don't know. But as long as you know the basics, you're able to describe that to them. How about if somebody asks, and I know they probably have, what's a mutual fund? Do you know what that is? That's basic, right? Do you know what that is, right? Because a lot of these 401ks, 403bs, they're invested into stuff like this. Do you know what that is? So just know the basics. You don't have to know everything, in and out about the market, but just listen to the market. Go do some research. Take the initiative to learn, right? Because if we wait for Johnny to teach us everything, then we're going to be behind, right? So take the initiative. Go understand. If you guys are financial professionals, we should be understanding what is the market doing? How is your 401k, 403b, TSP losing money, right? Because again, the more you know, the more I could explain and the more that the client's going to trust me. Just the other day or just yesterday, I had a teammate, right? She's a financial advisor. The financial advisor, told her one thing, hey, put your money in money market funds and this and that. I had to describe to the client, right? No, well, yeah, I mean, it's a good product, but let me show you how this could be better, how this could benefit you a lot more, and tell you what is a money market fund, right? What's a money market account? There's two different things, right? So if you do that, they'll be able to trust you. And also think about this, guys. What is an IUL? How do you make money in an IUL? Yeah, when the market goes up, you go up. When the market goes down, you lose. But how? How is it divided? How do I make money? So if I'm your client, I say, hey, Eddie, how do I make money on this? Are you able to go in there and say, hey, well, 50% goes to either the S&P or the Euro stocks, whichever one is higher, 30% goes to the one that's not higher, and then 20 goes to the Hang Seng. Well, Mr. and Mrs. Client, let me go ahead and show you how we go point to point and how much you're gonna make that month, right? But if I don't know how to do that, how are they gonna trust me? All I'm gonna say is, hey, look, you go with the S&P 500 and the Euro stocks and Hang Seng and that's how we get it. Now, somebody who doesn't know stocks will be like, okay, I mean, I don't understand it. But think about if you did know. If you understood it and you explained it to them in simplest terms, they're gonna trust you. Or how about if you get a high client, right? Recently, we got several high net worth clients. They all know about the market. Their first question is, show me how my account grows, right? How does it work? From point to point, what am I investing in? You could easily, pull up the S&P, the Euro stocks, the Hang Seng, go point to point and show them, how this makes money. So you could see the importance of just knowing the basics, right? And here's some books that you need to read, right? I would say The Power of Zero, David McKnight, which we just had the author, right? In Arizona and in Tennessee. The Retirement Miracle, The Creature of Jekyll Island, which talks about money, how money was created, and the psychology of money, right? These are four, big books that I would suggest that you read to understand so you could better help your client. So you could better help your teammates, help them understand, and again, create that duplication. If you understand, you get them to understand. It's a trickle effect. So awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and go into recognition, right? Before I turn it over to Mr. Jeff Albrecht, we're gonna go into recognition. Why? Because it's fun to
Are you
recognize,
going to
right?
let the
It's fun to recognize, and it's end of the year. So let's go ahead and recognize people for savings for this month. Let me put some music on. It's always fun with music, right? And where are you guys on this list? You guys always want to be on this list and be on the top of the list. All right. Here we go. Share my screen. Appreciate you guys' patience. And we go. Awesome. December savings. So, let's clap it up. Oh. happy. Vivian 585, Diana Ruiz 810, Abby 1007, Honey's 1400, Marianne Evans 2000.
I do the same thing. I told you that I never would. I told you I changed. Even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay. Need you to stay. I get drunk, wake up, I'm wasted. Right. I do the same thing. I told you that I never would. I told you I changed. Even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay.
Life changing. So, congrats. So, with that said, I have the honor and pleasure of bringing up the next host or the next guest, right? This is a guy who was like a Johnny to his real estate company. Right. My friends and I, we call him the Black Mamba. Or I'm sorry, the White Mamba. Reason why? Because this guy, he did teach basketball for some time at a D1 college school. And a friend and somebody who, you know, grew big in this business very quick. Right. Doing big things. And I know that he's going to continue to do big things as time goes on. Right. It's somebody that a lot of us look up to, Johnny especially as well. He talks about him all the time. So with that said, let me bring up Mr. Jeff Albrick.
Hey, Eddie. Thank you very much. How's it, everybody? Happy, happy last Saturday of the year. By the way, Eddie, question for you. Okay. What kind of whip you getting your son for his 16th birthday tomorrow?
He doesn't drive yet.
Okay. He doesn't want to drive. I'll teach you a little bit something today where you can get him a real nice car when he's ready to drive. All right. Yeah. Okay. So a little backstory here, guys. 6:30 last night, I get a phone. My phone rings. I'm driving to dinner. Okay. And it's Johnny. Anytime Johnny starts a conversation with "Yo," that means he wants something. He goes, "Yo, what are you doing?" I'm like, "I'm in Vegas. For those of you who don't know, I live in Hawaii. I'm in Vegas, going to go to dinner at the Bellagio with a client. We're going to talk about personal production. Why, what's up? Well, can you help me out with doing my base shop training tomorrow?" I'm like, "Yeah, sure, no problem." So it was a late night, bear with me, guys. But we're going to talk about personal production today. And you're like, "Why personal production?" Well, here's the thing. I want you guys to start changing your mindset about personal production. See, we always talk about building a big business, right? And we talk about recruiting and training and everything like that. But many of you on this call are fairly new, less than a year into the business, maybe less than 6 months, maybe less than 3 months. Okay. And when you're building a big business, you still have to supplement your business, right? Otherwise, your business is going to go broke. Huh. Any of you guys feel that way right now? A little tight? Okay. This is where personal production comes into play. Okay. Think of it this way. Okay. You guys all know who Amazon is, the company, right? Yeah. Amazon was formed in 1994, back in the 206, where I'm from, Seattle. Okay. In 1994, for those of you who don't know, what did Amazon sell? Amazon sold online books. Online books. Amazon did not have any platform for companies. Okay, think of it related to our business. You get started. You don't have a lot of maybe licenses. Maybe you don't have a lot of net licenses yet. So how are you going to survive? Well, you're going to survive by doing personal production. By doing personal production. And that will allow you to build into a big platform and also earn passive income just like Amazon does. So think of yourself as Amazon. Think of yourself as Amazon, okay? So why do we want to do personal production? Well, we want to build a big organization. But the number one reason is cash flow. Cash flow. Cash is king, ladies and gentlemen. Cash is king. Okay. The second reason we want to do personal production is to set an example for all our business partners that we bring in. Because if you do not do personal production, why are they going to do personal production? What do you have to give to them? Okay. Also, another reason to do personal production is experience. Because as you do more and more, I'll tell you what, every transaction I do, I learn something new. Eddie was just showing you guys all the different things that we have going on. Trust me, there's a lot to know. And by experiencing and doing your own personal, now you're able to help other people when they come across situations that they may arise. And then the last reason we do personal production is for longevity. Why do businesses go out of business? Because they don't make money. How do you make money? Personal production. It starts with you. Take care of number one first, and then you can take care of everybody else first after that. Okay, so here we go. So let's get into it. Calculating premiums. So how do we figure out how much personal production we need to do? Well, that depends on you, ladies and gentlemen. That depends on you. What do you need to do? What is your goal? For example, maybe you are part-time. Maybe you're just looking to earn $2,000 to $3,000 a month to supplement your income, to pay for your child's school, to go on a vacation, whatever, to put money away. You have to actually set an actual number that you're going to obtain. You are looking to replace your job and build this business. So you need to earn that much money, however much money you bring in a month, to take care of that. So here's the thing. Before you even think about doing this full time, let me repeat this. Before you even think about doing this business full time, you better have enough in personal production. I'm not talking about your team, but in personal production that you can replace your income. Think about that. And then after, maybe you do it for a month, maybe you do it for 2 months, but what about 3 months, 4 months, 6 months down the road? Are you disciplined in doing that? So a lot of people ask, okay, Jeff, well, okay, how do I actually calculate my personal production? All right, I'm going to share something with you guys. Bear with me. Once again, I'm in a hotel room. All right. My head's spinning still. All right. But I'm going to share with you guys a little, I guess I got called a, it's an actual calculation on how to produce or how to calculate what you need to do. Okay. And here's the thing about this. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, if you are a, let's just say a MD or even an SMD, and you want to teach someone how to go ahead and learn how we get compensated, then this is an actual wonderful, I would say, tool for you guys to use. Okay. But first off, let me actually bring it up. So personal comp, personal, I see personal compensation. All right, so I can't bring it up. So we'll stop sharing. Here we go. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to calculate basically how much money you want to make a year or even a month. So let's say it's $5,000 a month. The second thing you need to do is you need to find out what your contract level is. Okay. If you're a training associate, you're at 30%. If you're an associate, you're at 45%. If you are an MD, you're at 62, and SMD at 80%. SAs, there's a few SAs probably on this, you're at 55%. Okay. So you calculate how much money you want to make. Now you divide that by your contract level. So let's say you want to make $5,000 as a training associate. 30% of 5,000 off the top of my head, that's about $16,666. I should be correct if anybody wants to fact check me. Okay. I do numbers all day long. So that means you need to do $16,666 of premium. All right. Now divide that number. So we have the 5,000, divide it by your contract level, divide it by 12 months. 12 months, that will bring you exactly how much premium you need to do in a month. Are you guys with me? Sorry, I can't share with this because my internet's horrible right now. But if you do that, let's do the math up front. $16,666 divided by 12. That's $1,388 in premium. Personal premium. Okay, I would do personal premium. Now divide that by four each week. So 1,388 divided by four is a total of $347 a week that you need to close personal production. If you close $347 a week, you will earn $5,000 a month. Think about this. Nothing else matters. All your other brokers that you have, all your other team members, whatever they bring in, that is your profit. If you're going to make it in this business, you actually have to pay your expenses with your personal production. Anything above that is your profit. I'll give you an example. When I was running that real estate company in up in Seattle, I had 355 brokers. We sold $1.5 billion in residential real estate a year. That's 4,600 homes a year. Okay. Now I had 100 out of those 355, I had 128 cappers, meaning this. They did over a hundred, they made over $100,000 a year. Some of them six figures, some of them seven figures. But here's the thing. All of them paid my expenses. The rest of them, your brokers, the rest of them were my profits. So think of it this way. Your expenses, your household expenses, whatever it is, needs to be covered by your personal production. Do not count on your teammates to cover your expenses. If you are not doing your own personal production to cover your expenses, then you are doing something wrong. Now, you're probably saying, okay, Jeff, that's cool. That's great. But how exactly do I get personal production? Well, there's a couple ways. Obviously, the low-hanging fruit, our friends, our family, things like that. It's probably pretty easy to start off to get personal production from them, right? Now, how do we sustain that personal production? Well, here's a second way. You recruit. So there's more reasons to recruit than just to build a big team. I'm telling you guys, it's okay to be selfish. You recruit because you want to get them personal strategies. When you recruit, that means you are going to obviously help them with a strategy, set it up, and that will be personal production for yourself. And eventually, you will train them. And when you train them, guess what? You earn 30%. Guys, notice on that recognition, Johnny was on there. 2000. I guarantee for a fact, none of that was him going out there and meeting up with some client, right? It was all that 30% that 2000 came from. That's how he gets his personal production. Very rarely, because I was in Johnny's base shop for a while, very rarely will Johnny have a client, or every once in a while have a past client or something like that. He'll get a phone call. But it's all about that 30%. So personal production, set up appointments, low-hanging fruit, friends, families, recruit, and then become a trainer, a system trainer. And when you train, you're going to receive 30%. Here's another way. Simply ask questions. So I was at dinner last night, and I overheard at the table next to us a couple talking about their investments. Ding, 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 ding. There goes the radar. So they're talking, and anyways, I found a way to strike up a conversation with them. And I said, "Hey, so what is your, I overheard you talking about investments and things like that. So what is your goal for 2024? Where do you want to be by the end of it in your investments?" So they told me. I said, "Oh, that's great." So most people don't know those things. What is your goal in 10, 20, 30 years from now? They had no clue. So now what I'm saying is ask questions. Ask questions. And make them think. And then if you ask questions that make people think, guess what? That's going to lead to your personal production. Because when you ask a question that makes somebody think, now you all of a sudden you brought value to them. Okay. So here's four ways to get personal production. Low-hanging fruit, friends, families. Okay. Second, recruit. Get them a strategy. Third, be a trainer. Become a trainer. Get that 30%, go on appointments. And lastly, just ask questions. Notice I didn't say, I never even told them, by the way, I never even told them that I was in finance or I financially literally educate people. I just ask questions. Oh, by the way, that led to an appointment. So when I get back January 7th, I actually get back January 6th. So January 7th on a Sunday, I have an appointment with them. Okay. All right. Now, what exactly do we track? Okay. This is really, really important. How do we, because I see people on the leaderboards that are consistent. And then I see people on the leaderboards that have a great month and then they go into the witness protection program. You don't see them around for 2, 3, 4 months. So how do you stay consistent with numbers are the language of business. If you do not track your numbers, you do not know your business, and you will not be consistent. You will have the ups and downs of being an entrepreneur, right? People say, entrepreneurship, yeah, there's a lot of this and a lot of that. It doesn't have to be that way, guys. If you're running your business like a business, it's going to look like this. It's going to go shoo, and boom. Okay. You want that curve right here. You don't want this. Looks like I'm doing the whatever. All right. So how do we do that? Well, we have to track our numbers. So let me see if my internet will let me share this time. And what numbers do we want to actually? Yeah, it's going to let me this time. Okay, good. What numbers do we want to track? Well, here's the digits that we need to track and how we track them. How many calls and texts that you make a day? By the way, this is what I track. I want to talk to 20 people in a day. 20. That's my goal. And when I say talk, I make a call. If they don't answer, that's not a contact. Just because you made a call or just because you text somebody, they don't reply back, that does not count as a contact. Why do I want to track that? Well, because I know if I'm going to make 20 contacts, or excuse me, if I'm going to have 20 contacts, I'm probably going to have to text or call probably at least 40 people on average. Now, some of those people get back to me later, which is cool. I can not mark it off for the next day. So that's important. Now, out of those contacts made, I'm going to track how many appointments that I actually make out of those 20 contacts. Now, it's going to vary because sometimes I'm just touching base with somebody. I'm not always looking, I'm just catching up. I'm not always looking for an appointment at that point. What I'm doing is I'm touching base with them and then I'm telling them a little bit about what I do. And I say, hey, but that's not the reason why I called, or that's not the reason I'm reaching out. I just want to see how you're doing. You know what? I got to run to an appointment, but I'll tell you what, I'll circle back to you with you in a week or so. Is that cool? Great. Notice that, guys? Some things aren't taught, they're caught. It's a takeaway. See, a contact or a call is not always about setting an appointment. It's about planting a seed too. Okay. So I want to know how many calls I need to make and able to contact or make 20 contacts. I already tell you it's 40. And by the way, you're thinking 40 is a lot. It's really not that hard. You could text 40 people while I'm talking, right? And then how many appointments do I make out of those 20 contacts? I guarantee you, ready for this? Out of those 20 contacts, some of them are one-way calls, some of them are straightforward. Out of those 20 contacts a day, I guarantee I'm going to get 3 appointments set. Out of those 3 appointments set, okay, I'm going to go on 2 of them. Why 2? Well, because sometimes people just dog you out. Sometimes things come up, right? So now I know that I make 40 calls, 40 texts, 40 calls or texts. I contact 20 people. I set 3 appointments. I know that out of those 3, I'm going to go on 2. Out of those 2, I'm probably going to get a recruit, ding, 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 personal protection. And I'm probably going to get a policy closed. Now, I know 1 out of 3, they say every 3 appointments you go on, you're going to get 1 result. Well, I've been doing this for 3 years, so I know my numbers. 1 out of every 2, I'm going to close. You guys think I know my numbers? And then I know what my average savings strategy is. This is what you guys need to know. What is your average take in to affect all the Everest, all the term, the annuities, the IULs, and average it out? Okay. I can tell you for a fact that my average, if you add all those together, is $443. Pretty good. Because we've done, I think 27 ever so far this year. Those aren't always the biggest ones. But $443 times 12, that's 5,316 points times 80%. That's an average of $4,200 right there. Okay. So I can tell you how much an appointment is worth. When I go on an appointment, I close 1 out of every 2. Every appointment, even if they don't get a strategy, I'm making $2,100. Think of it that way. And this is personal protection. I know for every contact that is made, every contact that is made, this is what I'm going to make. Every contact, I want you guys to start thinking about this. $2,100 divided by 20. Every time I contact somebody, I just made 105 bucks. Think of it that way. These are the numbers. These are the things that you should be tracking. And these are the things that you need to know for your business. And that will help you understand why personal production is so important. And personal production is going to lead you to build a big, consistent organization. Because without personal production, without tracking the numbers, without knowing your numbers, you're trying to get to a destination that doesn't exist. It's like you're getting into a car and you just start driving. And wherever you end up is where you end up. See, your destination should be actually a total, what is it? Is it a cash flow? You know, it drives me nuts when people say, I would interview people. I used to recruit brand new agents. I used to recruit agents that made over $1 million a year. Okay. But the brand new agents, I'd always ask them, all right, so what is your goal? Why are you getting into this business? This is real estate. I want to make six figures. Okay. Is that 100,000? Is that 999? By when? Okay. What is it? So what is your goal? What is your goal? Your goal should be this. I want to make $5,000 a month. Okay. No problem. You can do that. Even as a training associate, just do $347 a month. Okay. It's sick what an MD is. For you guys that are MDs, if you're not making 5,000 personal production, okay, I think it's like $148 or something a month. Go do two evers. Seriously, two evers a week. And that will get you $5,000. I want you guys to start thinking about that. If you are an MD and you're not making $5,000 personal production a month, shame on you. It's real talk right there. That's real talk. And oh, by the way, if you're an MD, you're probably training, aren't you? You're probably helping your associates and your training associates. You're probably earning 30% personal right there. Yeah. Makes you stop and think for a second, huh? Okay. So, in closing, I wanted to change your mindset about personal production. See, sometimes you need to get a little selfish in order to lead others. Because if you can't lead yourself, you're definitely not going to lead other people. See, I tell everybody this, how you participate in here is how you're going to participate out there. It goes the same for your business. How you participate in your personal production is how basically you're going to participate in helping other people. If you can't even do your own personal production to keep your business up and running, how do you expect others to do that? So I wanted to get on here and I wanted to share with you and change your mindset about personal production. Okay. And I think you guys should have that separate goal than just building your own team and your own base shop. You've got to have your own personal production as well and a goal. And guess what? It's very simple to do that. There's different ways. Okay. The low-hanging fruit, the recruits, the training, and having conversations. All right. All right. I hope you all have a wonderful, wonderful new year. I'm going to turn this back to you, Eddie, and I'm going to go. I got a lunch appointment. Okay, I got some things to do, but I wish you all the best, and you have a good day.
Awesome. Appreciate that, Jeff. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So, I learned a lot myself, to be honest with you, right? Be selfish sometimes, right? Understand to be selfish. It's not something bad. Why? Because if I got bills to pay, who's going to pay them? I got to pay them, right? No one's going to pay my bills. Therefore, I do got to understand that personal production is so important, right? It's so important. And it goes along with recruiting. Why? Because when you recruit, you internal consumption, right? You do have to give a strategy to those recruits. So it helps. It goes hand in hand, right? At the same time, track your numbers. See, a lot of us have never been business owners. So Jeff's right, right? Track your numbers. I didn't know how to do that at first. Why? Because I always did it for somebody else. But it's funny how when it comes to you, then we don't track it, even though we did it for somebody else before. You know, it's crazy how it works, and you're gonna have ups and downs in this business, but like Jeff said, make sure that you do have personal production, and once you do that, grow your team, recruit, and then you have internal consumption thereafter. I like what he said as well, right? Ask questions when you're around other people, right? He was around somebody, a couple when he was eating. Ask questions, right? And by asking those questions makes them think and gets you an appointment, right? Gets you an appointment because it has them thinking, it has them curious. Shoot, you're right. I never thought about that. You added value to that person, to that couple, right? And now he has an appointment. You know, it reminds me just the other day, I just helped somebody with an IRA, right? And by asking questions, let me just share this quick. Look, this lady, matter of fact, you know, it's a teammate. She's on here. She has an IRA, right? From 20, 2000, from December 2000. She put in 49,700, but she has 22,583, right? She lost over $20,000 in 20 years, right? Now, when I asked her for the PDF, you know, she provided it to me, but she said she never knew that she could lose money. Guys, that's a lot of people out there. They don't know that they can lose money. They don't understand. You got to ask the questions because they're never ever going to look at their sheet and understand what it says, right? A transaction, if you give me $1,000 and I lose 500 today, you're going to be pissed off and say, hey, give me my money back because you understand that transaction. But see, when people look at their PD at their 401ks, 403b, they don't understand it. Nobody sat with them and told them you can lose money. You're invested into these ETFs or mutual funds or whatever it's invested in. Nobody sat with them to talk to them about it. But if you sit, ask questions, right, and then you get the information, you can add value to them and you know, and therefore help them ultimately and get that personal production. And then from there, recruit them, right? Recruit them. So awesome training. Appreciate that, Jeff. Amazing, 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 amazing. So what I'm going to do now is pass it on to my sister. This lady has amassed a huge, huge group, right? A huge team. Every time I look up, her team is recruiting somebody. Right, they're nonstop recruiting, so she inspires me to recruit. Right, that's something a little bit that I lack on my end. She inspires me to recruit, to continue to push, right? And at the same time, she moves back and forth from I believe LA to New York. She has an amazing husband as well, Pierre. He helps me personally because I have somebody in New York, and New York is a different beast. If you guys are ever going to recruit anybody from New York, please reach out to Michelle and Pierre because they help me tremendously. It's a different animal. So, with that said, let me bring up Michelle. Again, your last name has too many syllables, so I don't even want to butcher it. So,
come on. Yeah, look, whoa, word. When I was a kid, I had a dream I would be the greatest. Whatever I did, whatever I wished, I was gonna make it. Me and my friends, we made a pact, yeah, we made a promise to put in the work, never give up, and keep it 100. And we did it, now we on our way to get it, yeah. Graduated on our way to be the greatest, yeah.
You know, gotta get the energy up, man, oh man. What an honor to be here today. Like, I am so excited. Like, Naomi, you don't know. This is my first time after I graduated out of Johnny's Bait Shop team back a long time ago. So for those of you guys that don't know me, my name is Michelle. Say it with me, Eddie. Malo. Bad. Baddest in the business, right? Malo. Loy On. There you go. So it's Malo Loy On, right? Originally from the Philippines, born and raised there until I moved here when I was 12 years old. I originally grew up in California for 16 years, and I moved to New York literally, what, 6 years ago, going on 7 years. And I wanted to build an organization outside of California. That was my immediate goal. And I wanted to reach out to multiple states. And that was my mindset when I started in this business. I even created this vision board to show all the different states all lighting up at the same time, because back then, a lot of you guys are born in the Zoom era. I wasn't. Back then, it was all in person, in the office, every single day. So it was a different environment. And the issue with that was that we're limited. We were just in California growing, Amanda, and that's it. No other state was growing. All the other state was struggling because we didn't have an outlet to train this type of knowledge that Jeff did, that Johnny does all the time, and then also Eddie and everybody else. So we have only a source of explosion only in Southern California. And we've tried to build in New York multiple times, and it explodes and then it dies out because there's no constant, when you want to create that fire to keep igniting, you throw wood in it, right? Well, the wood doesn't get thrown, and Zoom wasn't predominant. And I am grateful the fact that we transitioned out of just in-person events to also virtual, because now how many of you guys are outside of New in California? Just show of hands, especially for those of you guys that are that have your cameras on. Just show of hands. A lot of you. So back then, you wouldn't have thrived whatsoever because it was all in person and that's it. But now it doesn't matter where you are. You could be in Puerto Rico, you could be in Guam, you could be in Virginia, you could be in Florida, Ohio, New York. Now we're growing. So I'm excited because I miss this. I wish I was still in Johnny's bay shop, but I don't wish it because I run my own bay shop now as one of the senior marketing director in the firm. And I'm grateful because I learned the fundamentals in this meetings right here. So for those of you guys that you see yourself being an agency owner, being a builder, having passive income and training other people, learn as much as possible because you don't want to take this for granted. Because after that, you're sales for the wolves. No, we're not going to throw you in the wolves, but you're out there now figuring everything out. You guys follow me so far when it comes to this? I'm fired up because also before I came here, usually our training in the East Coast is 10 a.m. as well, from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m., but East Coast time. So we did our training about a couple hours ago and we finished already. And we wanted to be so energized because we know this is the last training of the year. And we want to walk in with the right mindset, with the right thinking. And then also, why do we need to focus on personal production? Why do we need, when it comes to focusing on increasing the amount of people we're helping, and why do we need to focus on recruiting? So I actually want to give you guys a taste of it since we have a little bit more of a time, and then I'll go over the closing if you don't mind, because hey, I give it up to this bay shop right here because you guys are the fundamentals of everything that Johnny teach us. And I hope you see yourself popping out as a senior marketing director as soon as possible, right? And running your own bay shop team because I was so hungry to get out, but I also miss being part of this. So, anyways, let's go ahead and dive into it. Now, I need everybody's participation. Just because Johnny's here doesn't mean that you should be distracted. This is your business at the end of the day. Whether Johnny is here or not, you should be zoning and investing on yourself. Wouldn't you guys agree when it comes to that? So, because you have to run this one of these days. So, now when it comes to the participation, I want to know from everybody, what do you think are the major amount of money people try to save for in life? Can everyone feel free to unmute? Well, can everybody unmute, by the way, just to check? I don't know if Johnny locked the mute button here. Okay, a lot of people can unmute. Okay, good. So, can anyone tell me what are the major, savings people usually plan for? It's the same question I asked my bae shop, my team earlier. So don't be shy. You can unmute and call it out loud so that it's not a boring meeting where you got everyone
Retirement.
participating.
Retirement.
Okay, one person said retirement. Okay,
Buying
great.
a first home.
Buying a first home. I love that. So I'm gonna put that in here. Let me know if you guys can see my screen. It's gonna take a minute to load up. So keep going. So we got a retirement, we got buying a home. What else?
Education.
Education. By the way, if you're putting it in the chat, I can't see the chat while I'm sharing the screen, so you have to verbalize it. So, home, retirement,
Vacation.
education. What else?
Vacations.
Very good. Vacation or travels. What else,
Weddings.
guys? Weddings? Absolutely. Weddings is not that easy. You gotta prepare for it and have some
And
money for that.
funerals.
Been out by now.
Funeral. Oh, wow.
Generational wealth.
Generational wealth. So investing and generational wealth. Funerals, I don't know. A lot of people don't save for funerals. That's why GoFundMe is massive. It's not like people's number one priority, but that's good. So investing and generational wealth. Anyone else?
A
What
car
about
for your children.
for your children, which is education, or just for future of the kids,
A
right?
farm.
A car,
Sorry.
absolutely. And wouldn't you guys agree, emergency funds too? And car. So these are what people wanted to save for. And these are some of the things that are big ticket items, so to say, right? Needs a lot of money in order for us to accomplish this, correct? So these are
Right.
some things that most people don't think about ahead of time and then plan how much money should go there. So today I want to show you just a couple of reasons why we recruit so much and why our focus is in recruiting, if you don't mind. So pay close attention, all right? Now, let's just say the calculation is pretty much the same thing on everything, with the exception of retirement. But let's just say I want to buy a home. And any of you want to be a home buyer? Anyone? Raise your hand. I see Elizabeth giving me that. Ryla, beautiful. We have a couple of people that wants to own a home. I know we're close. I see Dahl also raise your hand. We're actually about to close on a home, a 4-bedroom home, but we also have a media home and a game room in Houston, Texas. So we're already at the final stage of buying the home there. It's about close to half a million. Beautiful. What 1.5 million looks like in New York, you buy that in Texas, in Houston, right? So at least you know where we're going. Nikisha, I got you, girl. I'm gonna be seeing you more often. But I say this because most people don't know how to reverse engineer the goals that they have. And this is very important too for ourselves, and not just for ourselves, for our teammates, because they tell you, hey, listen, I want to start this business because I want to be able to buy a home. I want to do this. I want to save up for my wedding. I want to, whatever it might be, as a trainer, you need to know how to help them get there. Alexa, stop. Alexa, turn the volume to zero. She reminds me about my appointment all the time, Gotta get reminders left to right. So excuse me on that. So right here, let's say, for instance, someone want to buy a home in 5 years. And let's say the home is about half a million dollars. Ideally, you want to set aside about how much? 20% down payment so you don't have to worry about any PMI and all the other craziness, and you'll have enough money too for closing. So many other factors that comes with it. Now, for those of you guys that are military personnel, you're amazing because you got a lot of benefits, so you don't have to go through as crazy of a process as any other ones outside of the military, okay? But usually this is the case, 20%. Now, some people put in less than 20% as down payment, absolutely. But at least you build up immediate equity for your home, and you'll have peace of mind too when you have a 20% down payment. So what's 20% of half a million? About 100,000. So what does that tell you? In 5 years, if you want to buy a home and you want to have that down payment ready to go, you need to start building one yesterday, right? But if you don't, then we got to start building one today. So Loida, I heard great things about you, Mrs., you know, pro annuity right there. We go to X-Wave and Johnny speaks so much about you. I finally got the chance to put a face in the name, and we've been looking forward. When Johnny talks about you guys, it's always in high regard. So yeah, you're the go-to queen of annuity, huh? All right. Keep killing it. Congratulations. I heard you're the new marketing director in this base shop. So I love
it. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. So anyways, let's go straight over here. So how much money is that we need to save? What if we don't put it somewhere that earns any interest rate? Let's say you're not part of the business. You don't know about IUL, right? Let's say we're just saving it out of pocket. Well, it's very simple. All you need to do is take a look at the amount that you need to save, right? And you divide that by the months you have left. Will give you the monthly savings. So if you want to save $100,000, and how many months in 5 years? Well, there's 12 months in a year, so that's about 60 months. Everybody follow me so far when it comes to this? Pretty simple math, right? So right here, you divide that by 60 months, which gives you about 1,666. I like to round it off to 1,700 a month. So outside from your bills, aside from paying your debt, you have to save how much? 1,700. Now, what if you want to buy the house next year? What if you want to buy the house 3 years from now? And what if you didn't have the savings yet? What are you going to do? Don't you think that's going to be a little bit higher or lower? Higher. Now, can you just go, Nishim and also Jamshay, like I know husband and wife, can you just go to your job and say, manager, boss, I need you to increase my income 1,700 more so I can start saving for my house on top of what already you're paying me? Can you just go to your manager and do that? What do you think your manager or your boss is going to tell you? Eddie, they're going to say, you're out of your mind. Either I'm going to fire you right now and find somebody else that costs less than you, or you just got to put your head down and just keep going. You can't. You can't just increase your income instantaneously. But the question is, can you do that in this business? Can you go ahead and just help 1 to 2 more clientele a month? Can you just increase the savings by identifying the needs out there? Can you just use the license that you all have, like we all have, and make sure it's actively being produced? That you're out there making an impact to families' lives. I say this is because at the end of the day, this is true to home buying. This is true to having a wedding. This is true when it comes to having kids' education, vacation, and everything else. Have you ever reverse engineered how much you actually need in order for you to accomplish your own personal goals? If you haven't, the year is almost over. We have today and tomorrow to start thinking about that right now, so you're not walking in to the brand new year without a plan. without a direction. So I say this to everyone because I agree with Jeff. Personal production should, number one, pay off all your bills, and you cannot be using what you override or everything else that your team does for anything else but saving it. So I know that I'm not going to rely on my team to produce. Never. I have bills to pay that needs to be predictable. Therefore, who can I control when it comes to those efforts? This person right here. I can't blame my team for not producing. I need to first produce and personally do it and make sure that my bills are constantly being paid. And then everything else is extra to build up all my goals and dreams. And if it's not, I'm going to keep building and mastering this business until I can reproduce myself or another person that wants it as bad as I do. See, this is home buying. I wish I have more time, which I think I can do retirement real quick. See, this is just home, okay? Now, when I saw this number, it opened my eyes up and said, Michelle, you don't have time to be lazy, because when I look at my numbers, Eddie, it was depressing. It was depressing me. So watch this. Retirement real quick. I'll go buy it fast. So let's say I'm 35 years old right now. Now I know some people are not 35, but that's why you use this formula and it can tell you exactly what you need to build to get to where you need to be. But let's say I just want to retire at 65 years old. Now, retirement for us is not the fact of just because of age. Retirement is just you have enough money to give you a choice whether or not you want to keep working or you don't have to. Most people, Jen, don't have a choice. So they have to keep working and working and working for the rest of their life. But imagine you build up enough asset that can supplement your retirement for the next 20, 30 years. Do you really have to work? Maybe you pursue something that you're passionate about, things that you've always dreamed of doing because you have enough funds to fund your dream. So right here, you got to understand, let's say you want an income every month, minimum $10,000 a month right now, right? For your retirement in the future. But the value of that is today's $10,000. But if you're not retiring right now and you're retiring in 30 years from now, you got to incorporate the word inflation. Wouldn't you agree that $10,000 20, 30 years ago is not the same $10,000 today? That $1 back then, I remember when I was a kid, I can buy a lot of different things with $1. Today, I can barely buy nothing with $1. That's called inflation. So we got to incorporate inflation, especially if you don't plan to retire anytime soon right now. So right here, usually the average inflation is about roughly 3% amongst 50 different states. But let's say, for instance, you live in California or New York or in the state of Florida. Those are the highest state inflation. The cost of living there is so high. That can range around 6 to 7%. So if we average the national to the state, the biggest state, let's just say 5% is the inflation rate. You learn about rule of 72. So 72 divided by 5, that gives you what? About roughly 14.4%. Wouldn't you guys agree? I rounded off to 15%. Why did I do this process? It's very simple. It tells you that for every 15 years, Avery, we need to make sure the money, that $10,000 that we want today, outpace inflation. It needs to double every 15 years in order to catch up with inflation. So this is going to be 20,000 15 years later, but I'm not retiring in 15 years. In this example, we're retiring what? 30 years. So I need to double it again to 40,000. That's 40,000 a month, which is equivalent to 10,000 today, right now, 30 years later, which is yearly, you multiply this by 12, that's about $480,000 yearly, almost half a million. You guys follow me so far when it comes to this? I'm going to show you my whole point regarding this, because when I saw this calculation and goal setting, it slapped me literally left to right. Why? I don't have time to waste, nor do I have time to be lazy or procrastinate. So watch this. If we know we need 480,000 a year that will provide us 40,000 a month, the question that people should be asking is, how much money should we save that just by living off interest, it will produce us 480,000 per year? You see? So let's say, what are there are different options to save our money? Number one, most commonplace, the bank. Bank can range to 1 to 2% in interest. Another one, people invest their money in bonds, which range around more or less 4%. Others put their money in real estate that usually yields somewhere around 8%, 6 to 8%. And then others, equity, right? That yields around what? Somewhere around 13 and above, more or less. So let's say when we save our money, we want to put it somewhere at the highest level of rate of return. And let's say we average around this to the top two and put it somewhere that earns 10%. Let's just say. So what we do is plug that number here. Now the question is, how much money should we be saving in 30 years? And out of just rate of return alone, we can live off that money so that we can pass the whole wealth to the next generation. Well, the formula is right here. If this factor is missing, all you need to do is divide 480 with 10%. What does that give you? About roughly, if I'm not mistaken, $4.8 million. Correct me if my numbers are wrong, but it should be pretty much accurate. All right. So this is the intent in 30 years. Now the question is, how much money should we be saving to build up to 4.8 million of assets? Have you ever asked that question? If you haven't, here you go. I'm going to give you a calculator. Let's plug the numbers in. Can everyone see my screen? Give me a thumbs up if so. I love this website. It has all the calculators that you'll ever need. And I'm going to share this in your screen just for you to have in your chat. So let's say you don't have no savings right now, and you need to reach $4.8 million. And you have 30 years time frame to save up. And you want to put it at an 8% or 10% rate of return. How much do you need to be saving every single month? $2,431. Wait, on top of the $1,700 for the monthly savings of the home. That's 10%. What if we change that to 8%? You need to save more. Can everybody see that? If it's too small, let me make it bigger for you so that you're not squinting your eyes. Can everyone see that? Now, again, going back to this, My question is for you, and this is only for home, and this is only for retirement. So if we add up 3,500 plus 1,700, what does that give you? About roughly, more or less, what? A little bit more than $5,000, correct? This is for the home purpose, and this is for retirement. Now my question is, do you have $5,200 every month to save? If your answer is no, the follow-up question is, do you have a way to make more money that will allow you to produce $5,200 a month extra, plus more than that? Because if your answer is yes, you're in the right place. And that's the reason why we get our license here. But wait, do you think people out there have an extra $5,200 on top of their bills, on top of all the expenses that they have, and they want to save for a wedding, and they want to save for college, and they want to do this for their kids, and they want to travel? I can tell you right now, majority of people, the answer is no. It's a heck no. That's why I love recruiting, because people don't have a freaking sign in their forehead saying, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. How come I'm not getting closer to the retirement goals that I need? How come I can't put my children in school? How come this is a problem where we can't get out of debt? Well, the answer is right in front of you. All you need to do is recruit people and get them licensed and help them make more money. You really think helping somebody save $200, $300, $500 is enough? No, not at all. And that's why, doll, I tell people, that's why you need to be in business with me. Especially when I sit down with those people, they're just like, oh, I don't know if I can open up a term. Oh, I don't know if I can open up $200 worth of IOL. Oh my God, $1,000 is very expensive to save. You know what I say to those people? This is the reason why you need to be in business with us. Let me show you a way where you can generate more income and help you really create the life that you want to live. And someone gave me that opportunity. Someone walked into my retail store and gave me that. And it helped me change the direction of my family's life. And I'm changing more families' lives because we want them to be part of here. You talk about the saying, you know, you can either give somebody, you know, a fish to eat for one day. But imagine if you teach them how to fish, they can eat for a lifetime. That's a Chinese proverb. So we all have that key to help people unlock an opportunity for them to change their life. And most people think that there's no way out. So that's the reason why, number one, I personally produce, because we need to save a lot of money. Having children, having a home is not, I know, that less of a responsibility. That's more responsibility to take care of. But if we want to build not just a lifestyle, and we want to build a net worth, Pierre and I have a conversation, and our conversation is that, yeah, babe, we need to save about $17,000 every month so that in June we get to celebrate a full savings of $100,000 cash. Because if we can learn to get out of that bad habit and save our first $100,000, then a quarter million, half a million, 1 million will be so easy to do. Everybody follow me so far when it comes to this. That's why I became licensed, and that's why I became an agency owner as quick as I can, so that, number one, I'm not losing money as a trainee associate. You know, there's a big difference between senior marketing director contract versus a trainee associate contract. How much? Thousands of dollars different. So as I close this out, you guys have been so kind to me and been so, so amazing. All of this that I showed you is the reason why we need to personally produce and why we need to focus on giving people opportunities out there and recruit them, because someone gave it to you. Why are you holding it to yourself? Don't be selfish. Give it and pay it forward to somebody else. Recruit more people. Now, of course, not everybody's going to do it, but the people that are hungry, that are willing, that wants to fight for their family will. And you'll find a Johnny, you'll find another Michelle, you'll find everybody that are hungry to win, that has that will to win. I promise you. But you can't quit, one. And two, you need to know how to deliver a powerful, passionate message to those, because they are waiting for you out there. I was waiting for someone to save it, to give me that opportunity. So, but of course, this will not be, I wouldn't be where I am today without an event to build me. And I say this to say, because at the end of the day, majority of you guys are in California. Right now, when it comes to this right here, Destiny, the rise of senior marketing director, a lot of you still penny pinch whether or not you should go to this event or wait until the increase in January 1st, the registration. Right now, there's only limited time, limited days before this event finish. So right here, you guys rank as the number one, but that's too small for all of you. You mean to tell me out of this base shop, you guys easily hit 100 people, but you're not bringing your spouse, your loved ones, your friends, people that should see it in the bigger vision? So if I were you, that's why for us, all of the people that register right here in my team are out of California. So what's your excuse? None of them are from California. So that means not only do we have to buy the ticket, we also have to buy the flight and we have to buy the accommodation. For those of you guys that are in California, shame on you if you still haven't registered. And shame on you if you plan to go there by yourself. You should be bringing 10 people with you, 5 people with you. I get intense, right? I got it from my mentor. I say this because don't take it lightly. And the reason why, by the way, my business has exploded, especially in the last couple years, is because I was built from event to event. And all the things I've learned, every single event has its own purpose and reasons. And every single one of that opened my mind about how can I get a winning edge for my business? Because at the end of the day, let me ask you this. If Johnny goes cuckoo, which I know he's not, but if Johnny disappears, is your business going to disappear because he disappeared? I sure am not. That's why whether Johnny is here or not, I'm the first one in the meeting. I'm intense in the meeting. I'm right here ready to go because I need to soak in and master my business, because this is Michelle and Pierre's business. And this is our legacy for our kids that we will transfer to the next generations to come, God willing. This year is the baby making season, guys, so pray for us. But I say this because, again, we love you. We care about you. Don't get left behind. I can tell you right now, every event can be your game changer. And the more people, Tracy, we bring in those events, the more people's lives is going to be changing. So it's been such an honor to be with you in this Saturday at the last training of the year. And I cannot wait to see all of you in person. And if you see me, come give me a hug. My love language is physical, so I would love to hug you and talk to you about your growth. So again, it's been an incredible time and such an honor to be here. Thank you, Eddie. Thank you, everyone. So other than that, let's kill it. Make sure you register. Don't not register. First of all, I want Johnny to look at the registration list and see what the heck happened in that meeting. And all of a sudden it went from 108 to like 120 and 130. Get one more person. Invest on yourself and invest on other people, because every single penny, you'll get back tenfold. Okay? All right, everyone. Take care. Have a good one. Peace out.